Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at Season 2, Episode 3 of Oshinoko, so let's get right to it. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, it'd really help a lot. Let's do it. Okay. Going to be starting the episode in 3, 2, 1, go. Back to the opening. But I guess that's how it was in season one. So what happened last episode? The mangaka came in and laid down the law, essentially. So I guess we're gonna see what the repercussions of the mangaka's decision to rewrite the whole script. He's probably gonna do it personally. Like oversee every aspect of it, and we'll see how the play turns out. Oh, it's Ruby. We haven't seen her in a long time. She's the opposite. Yeah, that's bragging. Oh, now she can't follow the conversation. That looked like something from the last season, I think. Oh, so it's all hanging on Kana? Like, they have to wait for her to finish? Oh no. That's right. They were going to go on a date. Go see an actual theater play. What's this about? Oh, it's a ping pong. What are you getting surprised for? Oh, we don't get to see like other elements of the stage play. Oh, he's been defeated. It's actually entertaining. My only question is this a real thing? I'm not sure. She's nerding out. I wonder if this is a real place. Oh, the producer shows himself. Oh, so you're running this one too. Oh, now the meat of the issue. Right. Yeah. Yeah, like last episode, yeah, I was going on about like how that sucks for the script writer. Yeah, it's always a communication issue. What do you mean, give it a nudge? So why are they here in the mangaka's apartment? Jesus. Jesus. She's going to drink by herself. Yeah. How do you do that? Okay. So they're going to go through, this artist. Oh, she's correct. Yeah, this is reminding me of Bakuman all over again. Wait, if that's the case, did she ever make a cameo in the previous season? Because I know they had a cut or two of this apartment, right? During like the first like episode 3 or 4 or whatever. Okay, so it's like inflated ego for going big, like, really quickly. Okay. Okay. Yeah, so it's the publisher's fault. They keep That is correct. Is she monologuing now? Okay. She's correct. She's correct. They did you dirty too. Oof, she's got to hear that. Oh, okay. So now we're back to reality. Goes back to the previous episode saying how it's her children. What is that? Uh-oh. You missed your deadline. You're too demanding. Two hours. Oof. What about the envelope? Jeez. That's right, it's unsustainable. Ooh, the hostage line. Blaming others. Correct. get him. Oh no. It's that, like, reverse psychology to motivate them to work. Oh, you forced it in. That's right, you're asking too much. It's unreasonable. How did she know about the little party? Oof. That was good though. She needed that. God, she looks dead. Okay, so that's gonna turn. I hope that turns her around, yeah. Flashback to when she got on as an assistant. Yeah, and then after seeing the drama, she'd be like, she'd feel jaded after that, yeah. Yeah, rewatch it. Oh, okay. That's what was inside the envelope. Yeah, go see it. Good. Good. I hope this, like, I hope it inspires her and she'll start learning how to compromise with the play staff. Yeah, that's what needs to happen. Good episode. Okay. That argument in the later half is probably the best part of that. Good. And then we just get to enjoy the ending. Glad we got to see a little bit of Ruby and Memcho. Even though it was only at, like, the beginning. Okay. All right, and that'll do it for episode 3. Thanks for watching along, guys. I'll see you guys next week for episode 4. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. See you guys next time.